So you want to know how to implement client prediction and server reconciliation. Well, first, let's understand what those words actually mean. When we have server authoritative code, we run into the problem where our input will not be responsive because we have to wait for the client to receive state from the server. So, client prediction is a technique used to make the client feel more responsive while keeping the server authoritative. In short, the client will update the game state immediately after receiving player input, and it will run the same exact code that the server is running. This will make the game feel more responsive. Server reconciliation sounds like a big word, and it is, but it's actually really easy to understand. To reconcile just means to restore friendly relations between. This means if we have predicted and somehow the client and the server have gotten out of sync with each other, then the server and client need to make it up and restore that harmony. So there's a couple things we must understand before we get into achieving the glory of client prediction and server reconciliation. One, deterministic program. A deterministic program or algorithm produces the very same output given the very same input. So for example, if you had a function called getSum and it took in two numbers, it should give you the sum of those two numbers, and it would be the same output every time you give the same input. If the getSum function were to add your numbers together, then multiply it by some random number, it would be non-deterministic because the output wouldn't be the same, it would change every time. So why is this important? Well, if you're trying to predict something that isn't really deterministic, then you'll run into a lot of problems with the server. Remember how you're supposed to make predictions on the client with the same exact code on the server? Well, if you're trying to predict something that's non-deterministic, then we'll have a lot of discrepancies and we'll have to reconcile, which means restore friendly relations between server and client. So, now that we understand determinism, let's get into some technical things. The second thing we need to understand is fixed tick rate. In order to compare the client and the server, we need to know what to compare. So say the client says, I moved 5 feet at 1:45 p.m. And then the server also says, I moved 5 feet at 1:45 p.m. When we check if we need to reconcile, we can look at our position at 1:45 p.m. to compare between the client and the server. And in this scenario, because they match, we don't actually have to reconcile. This makes sense, but there's a problem. We can't simply just use time because time is different across multiple devices. The time on my computer is slightly different than the time on your computer, and the time on the server is slightly different, so it wouldn't work out. So this is where we implement fixed tick rate. We can't simply just use the fixed update method in Unity. I won't go into too much detail, but here's an article that explains why if you'd like to see. Okay, so here's how I implement it. You'll run this code on both the client and the server. I'll start with the variables. I need a float timer to keep track of time passing, an integer called current tick, which is what tick we're on, a float min time between ticks to define how many seconds are between each tick, and lastly, a constant float server tick rate that just defines the FPS on the server. Then I'll move to the start function where I'll initialize min time between ticks, which is 1 divided by the server tick rate. So in this case, a tick will be processed every 0.033 seconds, which is 33 milliseconds. Then we move on to the update function. First, I increment the timer float by delta time. Then I set up a while loop, and while the timer is more than or equal to 33 milliseconds, I process a tick. Each tick process, I then subtract 33 milliseconds from the timer and run code for that tick. At the end of the tick process, I increment the current tick. The important thing to understand here is that an update frame is not the same as a tick. You could have more ticks in a single update frame, or you could have less ticks. But the important thing is that it's always fixed and should process every tick responsibly. Now that we have the fixed tick, let's get to client prediction. This will require code on both the client and the server. I currently just have mine set up on two separate game objects, where one of them is pretending to be the server. Let's start off with some data structures. We'll need an input payload struct that carries data about its respective tick, as well as the input. We'll also need a state payload struct, which carries data about its respective tick, as well as the position. Okay, now that we have that, we'll need to add more variables. I'll start off with the code we'll need on the client. We'll need to add a constant integer buffer size and set it to 1024. We need a state payload array called state buffer, an input payload array called input buffer, a state payload latest server state, as well as a state payload last processed state, and a float horizontal input and a float vertical input. In the start method, we now need to initialize both the state buffer and input buffer. Next, create a handle tick function, which should be called every tick in our fixed tick rate code. In here, we define a buffer index by doing current tick modulo buffer size. These buffers act as what's called a circular or cyclical buffer. If our current tick goes past our buffer size, the modulo operation will count up again. So for example, our buffer size is 1024. Once we get to tick 1025, this modulo operation will return 1, and 1026, it'll return 2, and we'll write over that spot in the buffer. Quite elegant, I must say. If it doesn't make sense, don't worry about it. You just have to stare at it a little longer. I've definitely been there. Next, we need to create a new input payload. Set the tick and input vector values. Add the input payload to the input buffer utilizing the buffer index we just obtained. Next, we need to add a new state payload to the state buffer utilizing the input payload we just created, and assigning that to a function called processMovement, which will return a state payload. In the processMovement function, define your movement code. Here, I am simply taking an input vector and adding it to my transform position. Important note, make sure you're multiplying things by the min time between ticks, which is 0.033 seconds, or 33 milliseconds in our case, rather than time.delta time. Next, return a new state payload with the same tick as the input payload and the new position. Back inside of the handle tick function, send the input payload to the server. Here I'm just writing some quote unquote mock code since I don't actually have a server set up for the example. In application, you'd send this data through some network protocol. Okay, now let's go to the server code. There will be duplicate code between the two, but I kept it separate because your server and client may be different code bases. All right, make sure you have the fixed tick code we implemented earlier on the server as well. Now, we need a constant integer buffer size set to 1024, same as the client. And we need a state payload array called state buffer, as well as an input payload queue called input queue. A queue in C# is kind of just an array with helpful functionality. Main things to note is there is an onQueue function which adds an item to the end of the queue, and a dequeue function which removes the oldest item in the queue and returns it. Next, go into the start method and initialize both the state buffer and input queue variables. After that, go into the handle tick function. Define a local variable buffer index and set it to -1. Then create a while loop, and we are going to quote unquote drain the input queue, which means we're going to dequeue each input load. We're then going to process the movement, and then we're going to update the state buffer. The process movement should be the same exact code that is on the client. Do a check if we've assigned the buffer index to something other than the default -1. If so, that means we've properly processed some input and send the new state to the client. Now we need to create the functions that receive the network messages on the client and server. Since we're already in the server, let's create a public onClientInput function, which takes an input payload parameter. Inside, we will onQueue the input payload parameter into the input queue. That's it for the server for now. Let's move back to the client. We need to create a public onServer movement state, which just takes a state payload parameter. Inside of the function, we assign the latest server state to the server state parameter. Now, in our update function, assign horizontal input and vertical input. Okay, at this point you should have the client prediction part finished, but now we need to implement server reconciliation. At the top of your handle tick function, do a check to see if we have a new server state that the client hasn't processed yet. If we do, then we call a function called handle server reconciliation. Inside of handle server reconciliation, we first assign the last processed state to latest server state. We obtain the buffer index for the latest server state tick. And we create a float position error, which is just the distance between the latest server state position and the state we have inside of the client for the respective tick.
Next, do a check to see if our error is acceptable. If it is not, then we need to reconcile. To reconcile, we need to correct the state in the client's state buffer and reprocess any ticks afterward that we may have already processed to correct those as well, because it's likely those will be incorrect too. To do this, we need to set the transform.position to latest server state.position. Then, update the state buffer at server state buffer index. Create an int tick to process, which is just the latest server state tick plus one. Then create a while loop. Here is where we'll reprocess all the states we've predicted. Create a state payload variable and set it equal to the return of our process movement function. Use the input buffer at tick to process as the parameter. Then get the buffer index of tick to process and update the state inside of the state buffer. Lastly, increment tick to process. Alright, you should be good to go. Let's hop back into Unity, hit play, and if you can see that we have client prediction. What I did is I just created a green cube for the client player, added the client script to it, and then I made an orange cube and then added the server script to it. If you are having problems or want to see the code, there will be a link in the description for the GitHub. It is a public repository, so you guys can go check it out. If you enjoy this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe for more. I'm glad you're here.